So in order to get the value of lambda, we are trying to write the L plus minus and the L minus plus multiplication in terms of L square and Lz. So we will have to prove a relation, means L plus and L minus in terms of L square and Lz. So we will prove that the L plus minus L minus plus is equal to L square minus Lz plus minus H bar Lz. We will have to prove this relation. So let's start from here. L plus minus L minus plus, this is equal to Lx plus Ily, so minus here, plus minus, and Lx minus plus Ily. Now do the direct multiplication, and this multiplication will be, we will have Lx into Lx, so Lx square plus, when this is plus, this one is minus, when this is minus, this one is plus, so our result will always here will be minus. This multiplication will always give us minus, and I square will give another minus, so we will have plus Ly square. Similarly, the next term that will multiply, this Lx will multiply with this, so it will be minus plus I Lx Ly, and when this term is multiplied with this, so plus minus I Ly and Lx. So we have from here, I can write this is combined, so Lx squared plus Ly squared, and then let me take the minus plus I is common, then I will get Lx Ly, and here will be minus, because when I take minus plus here, so I will have minus here and this will become plus. So I will have minus Ly and Lx. And I know that this thing Lx Ly minus Ly Lx from my previous relation, I know that this is Ih bar Lz. This is Ih bar Lz. So I will get that this is Lx squared plus Ly squared minus plus, and I will write one I from here and one I from here, H bar Lz. And this is equal to Lx squared plus Ly square, when this is minus, so I will have ii square and it will become plus. When this is plus and I square is minus, so it will invert and it will become plus minus H bar and Lz. So I got from here that if I want to write now this thing in the form of L square, then this can be written as L square minus Lz square, because L square is equal to Lx square plus Ly square plus Lz square. So if I write minus Lz square here, so that will cancel and we will have this plus minus H bar LZ. And if I look here, means here is a square. So we have proved the relation that L plus minus L minus plus is equal to L square minus LZ square plus minus H bar LZ. This was the required relation. And why we were behind this relation, it will get clear in a moment that why we were behind this. So now, because we will utilize these two here, we have already found that on the top rung, when I apply LZ, means one of the component of the angular momentum, I will get the eigenvalue LH bar. But I don't know what will be the value or eigenvalue of when I apply L square on the top rung. So I'm behind this one to find this lambda. Now we are ready after this relation that is I can write L plus minus this. So let me apply now L square on FT, means L square on the top rung. So for L square, I am having two relations here, L plus minus and minus plus, means I can write from here L square will be L plus minus and minus plus plus L square plus minus H bar L bar Z. So if I want to write L square here, then it will become L plus minus and L minus plus. This will come here and become LZ squared. And when this one will come on this side, then the signs will invert and it will become minus plus L H bar LZ. And this is operated on FT. Now from here, I will have to select. I don't know that what will happen when L minus will apply on F of T. But I know that when L plus will apply on F of T, then it will give me 0. When L plus will apply on F of T, it will give 0. So I will only select the plus first. And in the second, when I will apply it on FB, I will select L minus. So when I select L plus, then this is L square FT, and this will be L minus here, because I will have to select plus here. So L minus L plus plus LZ square, and here I will select the plus H bar LZ and FT. So now I can apply this one. This implies that L square FT is equal L minus L plus FT plus LZ squared FT plus H bar LZ FT, and this is equal to, I know that this will go to 0 because there is no further any top rung available, so this will become 0. And when LZ, I can write this LZ into LZ FT. When LZ will apply on FT, I will get LH bar, and when it will again apply, I will scare another, I will get another LH bar. So it is L square H bar square FT plus H bar, and LZ applies here. So this is L H bar, here I get L, and this is H bar square and FT. This implies that L square FT is equal to, if I take L is common, then I will have L plus 1. And h bar square I take here is common, then this is f of t. And what does this mean? This implies that lambda comes out to be L into L plus 1 h bar squared. And this is the thing we were behind to find out lambda. But we cannot decide only on the top rung. We will have to go to the bottom rung as well. So here, one, we have found that lambda is equal to L into L plus 1 h bar squared. Now let's apply. Let's take the negative here. We took the positive first, and now we are taking the negative. So L squared f of b is equal, take the negative here, so plus minus and minus, L plus L minus f b plus L z squared f b, and minus, we will have to take minus h bar l z and f b. So now we will apply on this one. This is equal to, I know this one, that this goes to zero, because when L minus operates on FB, it will give me 0. This is equal to 0 plus LZ on FB. I know that when LZ operates on FB, I will get L bar value. L bar value will be the lowest value of L to be possible. So this will be L bar h L bar square h square f b plus minus h bar. So this will be L bar h bar square f b, and this implies that L square f b is equal, if I take L bar common here, then this is 1, L bar will remain here, minus 1 and h bar square f b. Now L square f b and L into L bar minus 1 h bar square f b. So this gives that lambda is equal to L bar minus 1 here, and to h bar square. So we got another value of lambda as well. For the top rung, we got this value, and for the bottom run we got this value. Now we will have to find out that what is the relation of L bar with L, because we are having a different value here and different value here. So, but both the values are supposed to be equal. So what will be the L bar value then in order for them to be equal? So we came to know that lambda is equal to L into L plus 1, and also this is equal to L bar minus 1, and this is only possible if I want to prove this equal to this, so f and only f, L bar is equal to minus L, then this will be minus L, minus L, minus 1, and it will become L square plus L, and this is L into L plus 1. So it means that L bar should be minus L. So for the top rung, we are having L square plus L, and for the bottom rung, it is minus L. So we started that L square of the eigenfunction f is lambda f, and the eigenfunction f will give for the Lz mu f. We started from there, and we came to know that lambda is L into L plus 1, while Lz are the mu f. Mu is from there we got this m h bar. This is h bar squared, and mu is m h bar, such that m is running from minus L plus 1 through 0, and through L from minus L to plus L means to plus L. So we are having the number of steps that we go here. These are actually n steps, and for each L, ML, write index L with it as well. ML will go 2L plus 1 values. For each L, ML will have 2L plus 1 values. Like we say that there will be 2L plus 1 rungs of the ladder for each L value. For example, if L will be equal to 1, we will have 3 values